Hello! And welcome to episode 89. For this 48-hour session, I'm joined by Thorp Lea and the fishery. We've already been doing a tutorial, which went quite well, didn't it, for him?
Went really well. He ended up with 66 fish in the end, 48 hours. He had an absolutely awesome time, he had low 20s, broke his personal record mirror, so he was well happy. Yeah,
so
good.
So I've come along to score. So yeah, as I said, I'm here for 48 hours. Right under the flight path of Heathrow Airport. If you can hear that. I haven't done any vlogging for a while. As I said in my last session, I've been concentrating on my syndicate lately, where I'm not allowed to vlog. Since my last vlog, I've only had one fish at me Cindy, although it was a decent one, which is a 30-pounder, £30 2 ounce to be precise. So I'll quickly show you that now. Right, so cracking fish that was. I was well happy to get that, but since then it's been a bit quiet for me on the syndicate. Anyway, that's then. This is now. Well, we're already fishing, aren't we? Well, say you've already been fishing 2 days.
7-0 already.
I'm not counting. So yeah, after Liam gave me that hammer in a year ago at Turley, was it 44-12, wasn't it?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, so I ain't gonna count. Anyway, should crack on with it. Let's go fishing.
Fish on of the vlog. Although Liam has had several fish already today. Just whacked out a bit of spod. And I think he might have heard his alarm going off while I was spodding as well. First fish on of the vlog.
This is the first one to make on the screaming tape. I probably heard on the background the camera noise. This is sort of like typical average of Thorp Lea, some 17, 18, 19 pounders. Not too bad looking fish. Caught on a white wafter and a PV bag of pellets over a load of spod mix. That's how I caught all the fish on the tuition with James. Like I say, at the start he had 66 fish at the end. In the end, biggest was 23 pounds. So keep going and hopefully get a few more Easter eggs. Put the rod back out there about 20 minutes after I had the other one. Same bit of area again. Just put a few spots out just to try and reactivate the area a bit because it went a bit quiet. Three or four spots out and went off in 2 minutes after, resulting in this 20 pound full mirror. Cracking fish, got the same tactic in little bags, load of bait going in, so it's working well. There's another one over the baited area, started spotting again and paid off again. Keep the bait going in and they'll come to you. The lake's really quiet at the moment, no one's catching anything. Just proves you keep putting the bait in and they'll come to you. Yeah, bye.
Right then guys, just a bit of an update time, still all quiet for me. You can probably see it in front of the camera and hear it on top of my shelter, but at the moment the weather's absolutely lashing down. But for some strange reason, so this is meant to be a runs water, but I am at the moment still waiting for my first fish. So not sure why I'm fishing 62 yards out. I was casting around with the old marker rod earlier on, you see my marker rod just to the right of shot, and found a nice little gravel spot at 62 yards out, 7 foot deep of water, and I've been sort of fishing one rod on it, the other rod sort of tight to it, but nothing happening, and that nasty white thing you can see going past center of shot, they've already been past my rods at close range and wiped out both of me rods, the little buggers. It's really, really weedy in the margins here, so not fishing back leads or flying back leads, got tight lines right out to me rigs to keep out of the marginal weed. And covered fishing tight lines, the bird life is a bit of a nightmare. But anyway, I'm going to have something to eat while I'm stuck in my shelter in this weather. Hopefully it won't be too long before I get my first fish.
Right guys, coming into the nightfall now. This is my 11th fish today. I haven't seen a lot else come out today. It's been pretty quiet compared to when I was taking James on swishing. It was just hectic as hell all the time. A bit slower, but managing to get a few still. Just keep the squad going out there. Introduced six spots into the swim, and that one went off. This one went off in 2 minutes. Nice 21 pound one. Taking on faster corn, soaked in a special liquid, which we'll be introducing soon, and a little bag of pellets. Doing the job all the time. Cracking fish. Let's get back.
Right then, guys. Taking a bit of time for me, but we saw the fish showing at long range, didn't we? But yeah. 100 plus yards, weren't they?
Yeah.
I'm not a brilliant caster, but I put a rod at about 90 yards, which this one went on. And was that your long range rod?
No, it was my baited area rod. They've just started to come more towards us now. Just kicked off and just had another one about 2 minutes ago as well. Put it back, put the rod straight back out, and had this one straight away within 2 minutes. So hopefully we'll get a fair few more.
Yeah, it's, I'm happy, not blanking. Right. Better get him back now.
Right, people. No idea what the time is, but second fish of session. Left arm rod. Not even sure what the bait was on because it's come off the hair, so. Bit slower session than what I thought it would be, but get getting them slowly. Let's get it back.
Right guys, morning. Reeled in last night about 11 o'clock, me and King did, because we were getting too many bites. Just put some more bait out this morning, resulting in this double take. Straight away, put 10 spots out, straight on it. Had three fish already now, put the first one back, so I wanted to get the rods back out there really quick. There's this one anyway, it's about 17 pound. And then you got this one as well. Calm down. This one as well. About 15 pound. Taking the same methods again, little PV bags. Keep that spot mix going in there. You've got a good chance. I'll show you what I'm using in the spod mix in a minute. Sure, mix it up and all that. Get these two back and see if I can get a few more. Right, just thought I'd give you a quick update. This is my 26th fish now. Not going too bad. It's been absolutely crazy this morning. Getting loads of bites. Keep the spod going in. This is the result. Top stuff.
But, morning guys. As you've already probably seen from this morning's footage, Liam's been fishing out of his skin to make this blog worth watching. I haven't been fishing as hard as I could because unfortunately I've hurt me back at the moment and I've been suffering and I've been in a bit slow motion this session, to say the least. Last night after I had that fish, swans wiped me out about 4 o'clock this morning, both rods. I wound both rods in and just said sod it, I'll wait till the morning before I start fishing again, and got up nice and early, didn't I?
Yeah, you got up at 8 o'clock.
But yeah, while I've been suffering with me back, me head's just not been in this session at all, unfortunately, at the moment. So that's why you see more of Liam rather than more of me. Well, even in the last blog I think we saw more of Liam than more of me, but yeah, that's why I've been in this much, just me head's not in it at the moment. But my rods are out now, I'm going to put a bit of spot out in a minute, but
yeah,
you're doing alright, aren't you?
Yeah, not too bad. Yeah. Like I said, I've had 26, seen the last one was a real nice little fish. Just keep the spot going, I've been up since 5 o'clock spotting. Been getting double takes and stuff, you'll be able to see some of the takes on camera with a bit of luck, some screamers. Just keep the bait going, I'll talk you through the bait and stuff I'm using in a bit. Just changed my tactics slightly because I'm going to start fishing zigs now, so I'm going to do some sloppy spotting and stuff. We'll see how that goes. Just put some sloppy spot out and had a bite on it straight away. Unfortunately, it snapped the zig up. But first chuck, and I had a bite straight away. So we'll keep it going in and see how we get on.
Top stuff. I've taught you well.
All right, I thought I'd just show you this one. only weighs about 12, 13 pounds, but it's a nice little scaly fish. Took it from the bottom again, a little white wafter, solid bag of pellets, and bait's still going in, so they're loving it. One you just see me playing in. Got this one, the floaters. I'm going to go back on the bottom in a minute, it's getting a bit windy fishing floaters, so get some more bait out there and keep trying to catch some more.
Right guys, third fish of the session for me. Showing fish on the surface out in a mill, and such tactics to think with. First fish I hooked on his egg, managed to slip the hook. Bit of a pug mouth this one. Lots of dead leap. Still be catching fish. Let's just get it back.
Well guys, I thought I'd just take a second mate to talk you through the rig I've been catching all my fish on. I'm using about a foot and a half of unleaded leader. There's loads of them out on the market now, submerge, this is avid pin down, they're all just as good as each other, down to a 2.5 ounce in long lead with a solid stem. Solid stem makes it better for wrapping the solid bag round, makes it a lot easier to tie the bag tighter and everything else. I'll show you to do that in a minute. The hook length is box reflex. About 3 inches of that, 3.5 inches of that, down to a size 8 mugger hook, big bit of shrink tube, sinker in the centre. Hook baits are little West Country baits, wafters, white wafters, the cream ones. That's what I've had the majority of my fishing. I've tried like plastic and stuff like that, but these seems to be out fishing plastic. The pellet mix I'm using is Mighty Mix from West Country Base also. Brilliant pellet mix, loads of different pellets in there as you can see. Good mixture, different breakdown times, different oils, so you've got constant attraction coming off them. I'm putting it into a Fox Rapid bag. I'll show you how to make that now. We do get the collar. Open the bag up a bit, force the collar inside itself like so, just tuck it around the outside, easy so far, put a bit of pellet in the bottom like so, then drop your hook bait in, hang the lead over the top with the leader, nice little slot there, put a bit of pellet on top of the hook bait, drop the lead down to the middle, bit in the centre. Put a bit more pellet in just to fill it over top of the lead. Just give it a tap down so you tap all the pellets down. Take all the gaps out. Twist it once. Then slip around the outside. And then just shove it over the top. Couldn't be easier than that, could it? So that's what I'm casting with spot. Just tuck the corners in as well. Just to make it a bit fly a bit better. I'm casting about 80 yards. So it does help. Aid that. And then before I cast out, just getting the goo, pineapple and caramel I'm using. Just put a couple of little blobs on the outside. Just colour the bag in. There you go. Simple as that. I thought I'd just take a second out to talk you through the rods I'm using. Just brand new rods I just got. Bradwin Rods, he's a custom rod builder. He makes absolutely brilliant rods. Nice cork handles, my cup of tea. Love cork handles. You can have like whatever colour ribbon you want there. You can have it all the way down the rod, like whip in there, whatever colour you want. Obviously I'm casting about 80 yards, it just makes the job so much easier. I've had a couple of people comment saying how easy it is for me to get the rod bait out there and stuff, casting the solid bags. So check out Bradwin Rods on Facebook. He makes absolutely good quality rods. Give him a message and stuff, and I'm sure he'll be able to sort you out if you wanted a custom build of your own. Alright guys, thought I'd just take a second out to talk you through like the spot mix I'm using. Like I keep saying throughout the video when I'm landing the fish and stuff, keep that bait going in on places like this, just ringing the dinner bell. They absolutely love the bait going in. As soon as you spod, you tend to get a few bites. So I'll talk you through making it. Right, first ingredient is sloppy spod from West Country Baits. Comes in 3 kilo buckets, makes an absolute lush cloud. It's got a cream enhancer in it, smells absolutely lush. The way you prepare that is, not where you're gonna go out, tip some hot water over it, give it a good stir around to make sure it's all damp, make sure there's no dry lumps and what in it, just leave it overnight, all the particles will absorb it in there, all the little seeds, and it's ready to go basically. True blue beater style, some I've done earlier, that's what it comes out like once it's damp. It's lovely and it's absolutely stinks of green. So a couple of spoonfuls of that goes in. That's adding the cloud factor, so that gives me fishing over zigs, and if I want some stuff to go down the bottom, just keep smiling the water to draw them in. That gives that as well. Next ingredient is hemp. Everyone knows how good hemp is. Oily as shit, creates a slick on the surface. So good lot of that as well, 1.5 things of that. Get a good mix round. The hemp will actually break down the cloud a bit, which is what I want it to do, so it doesn't all go down in one big clump. Next ingredient, good old fashioned sweet corn. Can't beat sweet corn, so good sprinkling of that. Get a good mix round. Right, next ingredient to give it some more slick is fishy slicks from West Country Baits. You've got an oily pellet in there and a protein pellet. Bigger pellets, like 6mm pellets, so they're not going to go to mush in this bob mix, they're going to hold together. So I'll put a few of them in. We've got a good mix round. Go, and that's the spod mix basically. Full of loads of little particles in there, keep the fish grubbing around for ages. Perfect for fishing venues like this. Keep the bait going in. Thank you. Fish on. So when you just see me playing in?
That is 21-2.
Too bad. Show me then.
Just reading me total carp there. Oh. Right guys, I'm catching them slowly. Four fish for me. My first fish that was worthy of being weighed at 19 pounds two. Left down rod, back on the baited spot. Absolutely steaming run. Little snowman rig consisted of one of Liam's baits and a little pink pop up on top of that.
Yeah, it's all good. Number 30 for me.
I'm only just behind.
Yeah, this one was probably about 18 pound over the baited spot again. I'm normally a bit slow about this time of night, but hope to get a kick back off again in the morning. They're pretty lively, so we'll get them back.
Morning guys, thought I'd just give a quick update. There's two in the net. I've already put two more back this morning. Puts me up to 38 fish now. It's going pretty well there on my spot like mad at the moment. Just had this double take obviously, so we'll get them out and give you a quick show of them.
Right, like I've just shown you, just had this double take. I've only had a chance for about three spots in this morning. I've had four fish already. I've only been fishing about half an hour. Wanged in last night. Got a bit hectic because I'm going home today, so I need to get a bit of sleep. It's got a long drive back. All the fish are coming on the white wafters now. Solid bags, like I showed you yesterday. Just keep that bait going in. There's the one anyway, probably about 16. And you've got this one's a bit smaller. Get a play ball. This one as well, for about 10-11 pound. Let's get them both back and get the rods back out. Alright, I just thought I'd talk you through. I've been showing a lot of like West Country Baits products throughout the session. That's what I've been using. I use them all the time, using down linear fisheries and etc. Places. I absolutely slaughter linear. Do a wicked range of freeze baits. I haven't used any of them this session because places like this, like the fluoro colours tend to work better. Whites work particularly well on this session, better than any other colour. Switch both rods to white in the end. But they do a range of all different ones, pinks, fluoro yellows. These are all little wafters, fruit ones. And look, I've been using the cream ones, white ones. We also do them in pop-ups, most pale pink. People, they're proven very popular with people. Obviously, like the quarter promoted pale pink, very good colour. Works everywhere. White's my favourite colour personally. Pellet mixes, like Mighty Mix I've been using. Absolutely brilliant pellet. I wouldn't use any other pellet. I wouldn't go fishing without pellet. Just absolutely brilliant stuff. Got mini marines. They're very popular in the Swindon area under a different name. Absolutely brilliant pellets. Probably the best fish catcher around. I haven't used them this session because I prefer the different breakdown time pellets, but an absolutely brilliant pellet anyway. Like I was saying, we've got a website coming up in about 2 weeks' time, so check out that at www.westcountrybaits.co.uk. So check out that. In the meantime, you can check out the Facebook, like us on Facebook, keep up to date with our posts and stuff like that. Watch out, guys, I've got another run on the bait now, alright? Fish on!
Yeah.
Proof in the pudding, it works. Right, just want to show you this one. Takes me up to 43 now. Still backing up, catching the water at the moment. So I've got about 3/4 of an hour left. See if I can get a couple more, but start backing away. So see what happens and tell you how many we've got at the end.
Alright then, guys, come to the end of our session now. It's been an okay session for me. I had 5 fish in the end. My fish I had last night I didn't show you because it was a bit of a scallywag to unhook and I didn't want to leave it out of the water longer than I had to just for filming purposes. So not as well as what Liam did though. You had just a few more than me, didn't you?
Yeah, just a few. In the end I ended up with 112 in total. While King's been here I've had 46 and I had 66 on tuition with James. So it's been all in all absolutely amazing session. Loads of 20s, average solid fish, 18 pound, can't want more really.
Yeah, so we worked out Liam's had an average of about about 2,000 pounds of fish. So pretty mental going.
Yeah, that's mental, yeah.
And I've probably had about 70 pounds of fish. But you know, it's always good to come to a venue for the first time and not to blank, so. But by all accounts, it is pretty impossible to blank here. But anyway, as you can probably see just behind us, gear on the barrow, which is Liam's, my gear's all packed up, ready to go. Going home, I think we both need showers, you do definitely.
Definitely, yeah.
Alright, anyway, thanks for watching this episode. I know you haven't really seen me in it much, but it's been more of a Liam blog this one, but.
It's all good.
Yeah. Right, anyway, thanks for watching. If you've liked watching Liam, give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you in the next vlog, which will be the YouTube Bloggers Match. Till then, tight lines.